Hello there, here we are again on the Mobile School Playground to introduce to you an all-time favorite board game, which is rather new on the Mobile School, and it's the Backgammon game. This game looks rather complex, but don't worry, in this video we will explain to you all the game rules so that you can take it with you on the streets and you can play it together with the kids. So what you need to play this game, you will need the Backgammon board game. You will need two dice, very important, and you will also need 15 red and 15 white bottle caps to start the game. You will also need two players for this game, so let us have a look at the game rules right now. First, let us have a look at how the game board looks like. You have different parts of the panels which you see. The most important thing is you will see over here that there's a red arrow and a white arrow. This means that all the red bottle caps of the player, will move clockwise. And all the bottle caps of the white player, they will move counterclockwise on the board. Moreover, you will also see the two home boards. This is the home board for the red player, and this is the home board for the white player. We already attached some bottle caps to the board. This is the official starting position of Backgammon, but of course when you lift the bottle caps you will see that they are also indicated on the panel to help you to start up the game. Which other elements are there in the game? You'll also see that in between these two parts of the board you will have what we call in Backgammon the bar. We will explain you how the bar works afterwards, and you will also see that there are two trays. You'll see that there's a red tray over here, and you will see that there is a white tray over here. And the main objective of the Backgammon game is to bear off all your checkers and to have all your checkers as soon as possible in the tray. And the player who will succeed in this, he will be the winner of the Backgammon game. Okay, so how do you start the game? You invite one player forward. Imagine A will be the white player. Then you invite that player to spin the disc twice. So I will spin the disc and it lands on 2. I'll spin it a second time and it lands on 3. So now I have a 2 and a 3 and a total of 5. Now I can move my checkers along the game board. So I can move, for example, this one 2 points, 1, 2, and I land over here. And let's say I move another one, maybe this one, 1, 2, 3. You see, I always move as white player in a counterclockwise direction. So you can also move one of the bottle caps 5 spaces forward. Let us try with this one. 1, 2. I can land over here, but then it says 1, 2, 3. I can't do this because this point is already occupied by the other player with 2 or more of his checkers. So I can't move over here. So I can do 2 with this one and then 1, 2, 3. So now the red player can take his turn. So imagine I'm the red player. I spin the disc first time, it lands on 6. I spin it a second time and it lands on 3, which is 9 in total. So I take one of my checkers on the board. Let me check. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's possible. 1, 2, 3. That's possible as well. So 9 in total. I can move 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. You will see right now that I land on a point where there is only one checker of my opponent. If this situation occurs, the white checker that was first on that point will move to the bar, and that point will only be occupied by a checker of the red player. Now the white team can only focus on getting this checker off the bar and back into the game board. So imagine I'm the white player again. I spin the disc twice, it lands on 6, and I spin again, it lands again on a 6. Then I'll need to try to find a space that's open for my checker to come off the bar. I'll say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, but you will see there are 5 red checkers over here, so I can't place my bottle cap over here. I had 2 times 6, so this means I lose my turn and my checker will need to stay on the bar. Imagine that I would have thrown something differently. Let's see, let's say a 4 and a 3. Then you can say, okay, I move 1, 2, 3, or 1, 2, 3, 4. And here is an open place, so then I can get my checker off the bar. You'll also notice in the beginning of the game, there's still a lot of space left, so probably you will be able to move your checker from the bar rather quickly. But during the game, when there are more red bottle caps in the red home board over here, it will become more and more difficult to get your checkers from the bar. So just pay attention that if you land on a specific point and there's only one bottle cap of your color, that you're very vulnerable for the other player and that he or she can throw you to the bar and that you can be stuck over there for quite a while. In the backgammon game, there are also a couple of special rules. Like, for example, if I need to spin the rotation disc and it lands on 3, I spin a second time and it lands on 3, so 2 times 3, then I can move the double of spaces forward. So, for example, I can take this one, I can move it 3 points forward, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, but since it's double, I can also move the same or another checker 2 times 3 spaces forward. So I can do 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, once again to secure this checker on the board. Another rule is as well that you can place as many checkers, as many bottle caps as you want on one point. So imagine a situation, you can add red bottle caps over here as many as you want. There's another special rule in backgammon with moving your checkers. Imagine I am a white player and I spin a 1 and a 3, for example. I want to move this bottle cap. I try 1, I can't land over here because there are like already 4 red bottle caps. I try 3, 1, 2, 3. There are also 2 bottle caps, so I need to find another checker to move on the game board. Imagine if this is the only move that I can make and the other points are occupied by the red player, I will just lose my turn. Of course, in this situation, how it is on the board right now, I can just take another checker and move it along the board. For example, over here, I can move this 1 and 1, 2, 3, and then I can still play this. So the backgammon game will continue, and the main objective, of course, is to get all your bottle caps in the home board. So if I'm the white player, you see the white dotted line over here. So this will be my home board. The home board for the red players will be here. So imagine after a while of playing the game, it might look something like this. I'll just place the red bottle caps over here. But once again, be careful, because even in your still vulnerable for the checkers of the other. Like, for example, there is only one checker on this point. Imagine a red bar. The red player throws 2, 3, 4. There's only one checker of the white player over there. Even if all your bottle caps are already in your home board, you're still vulnerable, so be thrown on the bar again, and then you need to start from scratch all over again with this checker. Why is this so important? In order to start bearing off your bottle caps from the board, you will need to have all your checkers, all your bottle caps inside your home board. If this is not the case, you are not able to start bearing off your checkers from the board. Okay, so let's go back to the situation where all the checkers are inside the home board. Now you can start what we call bearing off your checkers from the game board. So imagine this situation. I'm the white player. I spin the disc twice and it will land on a 6 and a 2, for example. Then I can take one of the bottle caps. I could try 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and I'm out, which is good. So I can place it over here. So this is one bottle cap that is already out of the game. And I still have a 2, so I can take another one, and I do 1, 2, which means I'm out, and I can place it in the tray over here. It's always important when you start bearing off your checkers from the game board that you try to do it with the exact number. If I have a 6, I need to pick a checker from this row to bear it off. If that's not possible, you can also bear off a checker with a higher number. So imagine all these checkers are gone. I only have this checker left and I throw a 3, for example. I can still take this one because there then will be no other checkers on the 3 point. So imagine a situation where there are only checkers left on the 6th point. And I throw, for example, a 2 and a 3, then I can still move my checkers within my home board. So I will not be able to bear them off, but I will be able to just move them 3 or 2 points forward. Just be careful, even inside your home board, you're still vulnerable for checkers coming off the bar from the other team. So if you only have one checker on a certain point, you will still be vulnerable and you can still be thrown to the bar, which means you need to start all over again with that checker to come back to your home board. So once again, the winner of the game will be the player who has all of his or her bottle caps in the tray. So that player will win the game. So I hope you right now understand how the backgammon game works. We hope you take it with you on the street one day to try it out with the kids and have fun during your interventions. Hope to see you very soon on the Mobile School Playground. Bye bye.